Good morning, everyone. I hope you are doing well. This is Ms. Pamela Tini giving the physics course for grade 11 American system. Today we are going to study chapter 5, section 2, friction. If you all can please open your books on page 130 so you can follow up with me. First of all, we are going to define friction. Friction is the force existing between two surfaces when they push against each other. So right now, between your shoes and the floor, there is friction. Between the wheels of the car and the ground, there is friction. On what does friction depend? Friction depends on two factors. First, the materials that the surfaces are made of. Rough surfaces exert more friction than smooth ones. For example, there is more friction between your shoes and concrete than there is between your socks and polished wood floor. You can also take the example of sand and ice. Sand is rough, so it exerts more friction than ice, which is smooth. The second factor is how hard the surfaces push against each other. The harder they push, the more the friction between them. Types of friction. There are several types of friction, but in this lesson we will study the two types which are related to displacement and force in two dimensions, which is the main idea of our chapter, chapter 5. The two types of friction are kinetic and static friction. First, kinetic friction. Kinetic friction is the force exerted on one surface by another when the two surfaces rub against each other, because one or both surfaces are moving. For example, the force between a couch and the floor when the couch is being pushed on the floor. So whenever there is motion, the friction is kinetic friction. Second kind is static friction. It is the force exerted on one surface by another when there is no motion between the two surfaces. For example, when you try to push a couch across the floor, if you exert a small force, it won't move because static friction between the couch and the floor opposes your force. However, there is a limit to how large the static friction force can be. Once your force is greater than this maximum static friction, the couch begins moving and kinetic friction begins to act on it. You can see figure 10, page 130, to see an image showing this example. So, in this example, they are telling us whenever there is an object at rest, there is static friction between this object and the surface on which it lays. This static friction has a maximum value. Once you start pushing this object, you have to reach a force greater than this maximum static friction so you can move the object across the surface. The relationship between kinetic friction force and normal force. There is a linear relationship between the kinetic friction force and the normal force. The slope of the line on a kinetic friction force versus normal force graph is designated UK and it's called the coefficient of kinetic friction. You can see figure 12, page 131 to see such a graph. So the coefficient of kinetic friction is the relationship or shows the linear relationship between two forces, the kinetic friction force and the normal force. To calculate kinetic friction, you use the following equation. FF kinetic, which is kinetic friction force measured in newtons, is equal to UK, which is the coefficient of kinetic friction, and it has no unit, multiplied by Fn, which is the normal force, and it's also measured in newton, of course, like all forces. Note, the coefficient of kinetic friction differs according to the surfaces. So the coefficient of kinetic friction between a table and the floor is different than the coefficient of kinetic friction between a table and sand. By rearrangement, you can calculate the coefficient of kinetic friction using the following equation. UK is equal to force of kinetic friction over normal force. You can also calculate the normal force using this equation. Fn is equal to the force of kinetic friction over UK. We have to remember that normal force is opposite to gravitational force in direction, but it's equal in magnitude. So if we need to calculate the normal force, we use the following equation. Fn is equal to minus m times g. Mass is in kilograms, of course, and g is the acceleration due to gravity equal to minus 9.8 newton per kilogram or meters per second squared. So if in the given you do not have the normal force, you have the mass, you can calculate the normal force and then continue. For example, you push a 30 kilogram wooden box across a wooden floor at a constant speed of 1 meter per second. The coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.2. How large is the force that you exert on the box? So, first of all, we can see in this example that the wooden box is moving, so the friction is kinetic and not static. First of all, we write the given. Mass is equal 30 kilograms and the coefficient is equal 0.2. Here you must remember that if the mass is given in grams, you divide by 1,000 to change it to kilograms. Then you calculate the normal force using the equation minus m times g equal to minus 30 times minus 9.8. The answer will be positive, of course, because the normal force is exerted upwards. Then you calculate the force of kinetic friction, which is equal to the force of the person on the box. So in the question, they want us to calculate the force that the person exerts on the box. This force is equal to the force of kinetic friction. It's equal to the coefficient times the normal force, equal to 0.2 times 294. Thus, the answer is 58.8 newtons. Please, as a homework, do numbers 18 and 20, page 133, and numbers 27 and 28, page 135. Thank you and good luck.